And finally, the former chief scientist, Alan Finkel, well, he might think that forests of wind turbines and fields of solar panels stretching as far as the eye can see are a vision splendour, but despite years and years of public subsidies, they're still generating only a tiny fraction of the world's power. Last year, says the Energy Institute's Statistical Review of World Energy, wind and solar power between them accounted for around 10% of total global energy usage. The much maligned fossil fuels of oil, gas and coal, altogether they accounted for almost 82% of total energy consumption, barely down on the previous year, despite the near ubiquitous virtue signalling and green chest thumping. Even in the electricity sector, last year, wind and solar were less than 12%, while coal and gas was at record highs. Yet somehow we think we can close all our coal-fired power stations within a decade and get some 70% of our electricity from wind and solar within just 7 years. Now, there's only one word for this: madness. Any wonder then that Sweden, yes, the land that gave us the child climate activist Greta Thunberg, has just announced it's scrapping its green energy targets because the finance minister who announced the scheme said Sweden needs a stable energy system. The minister, Elisabeth Svantesson, said that wind and solar are too unstable to meet the nation's energy requirements, saying this creates the conditions for nuclear power. Never thought I'd say it, but Energy Sense from Scandinavia, well, after Sweden's rejection of lockdowns and now this move on energy, I tell you, Sweden's fast becoming a beacon of rational common sense.